Hey guys, this is Mark. Welcome back. In my previous lecture, we talked about values and variables. And in this one, we are talking about data types. Values and variables are directly related to data types. In fact, every single value and the variable that contains a value will have a data type associated with it. At this point, you know there are strings and numbers as data types, but there are more. At the high level, every single value you'll be working with in your codeless logic will have a data type, and it's going to be either an object, and we will talk about objects extensively in the future lectures, and everything that is not an object will be a primitive value and will be a primitive data type. So those data types are strings, numbers, you know about them, but there is also Boolean, and there is also two special things such as null and undefined, and I will talk about those in this lecture as well. So let's just jump into it and talk about Booleans now. So a Boolean is a special data type that may contain two different values, either true and false. And then all the conditional logic that you will be building in the future will be based on a conditional Boolean value. So let's take a look at how it works in Codeless. Everything related to Booleans and conditional values you will find in the logic category right here. And you will see that there is this block that says true. So drag this out. And we will also bring the print block in back into this codeless logic. And let's connect this true to print. This is still logic. It doesn't really do a whole lot. It will just print out value true. In fact, let's take a look what it will look like. And as you can see here, it printed out true. True is printed out in purple color to indicate that it's different. Numbers, I believe strings are going to be printed out in this kind of light gray. Booleans are printed out in console in purple. In here, you can change from true to false, and that will be printed as such. Whenever you evaluate any kind of expression that results in true or false, that will be a Boolean value. So let's take a look at how that will work. Back in logic, you see that this block, it performs in here out of the box comparison. Drag this out, and you can see that there are some additional operators to compare, whether it equals or does not equal, less than, greater than, and so on. So in here, if you were to connect this comparison operator to print, and let's put this false in here. Now we can compare some other value with false. In fact, let's declare a variable, and I will call this variable my variable. And let's set this variable to the value of true, just like this. And then this variable, we will use this in the comparison. So in this case, what happens here is the variable value is set to true, and then we're comparing what sits inside of that variable to the value of false. And we're comparing whether they are equal. And let's see what the result of this will be. And the result is false, indeed, because true is not the same as false. It does not equal false. Very much expected. You can compare variables to other variables. You can compare static numbers to static numbers, strings to strings. All of that will work. And in fact, you can apply any of these comparison operators. The cool thing about Codeless is that a variable, once you put a value into it, the value that may change. And then you could put a Boolean value into a variable, and then you can put a numeric value into the variable, and you can still perform those comparison operators. And there are some interesting things that happen where you can actually compare a number to a Boolean value, you can compare a string to a Boolean value, and those are also valid cases. And we'll talk about that just so you understand how to deal with those situations accordingly. Sometimes in your codeless logic, you will need to determine the actual type of your value. And in order to determine the type, there is a special block that is in logic, and this is the block. And let me drag this out. And then what the block says is, and then you have some value, type of, and you can check the actual type. So using this block, you can determine whether your value is a, in this case, object or a number, Boolean or a string or undefined. And this becomes very handy because sometimes you need to determine what you got back, whether it's a number or a string or a Boolean. Let me demonstrate how that will work. So in here, let's connect this print to to this connect this block to the print. And in fact, this comparison could actually be used inside of this. So with this comparison, whenever we check this variable with the value false, what it does is it returns a Boolean value which indicates the result of this operation. So here we can check whether the result of this operation is Boolean, which really should be Boolean. And let's run this page. And you see that the result is true. So what happened here, we evaluated our variable against false. We got some result, whether it's true or false, but the point is that result is of type Boolean, and that's exactly what was printed out. Yes, it is a result that it is Boolean, that it's true. And then if we check it against string and rerun this page, the result is false. So what happens here is this was evaluated. It was Boolean because we know that the comparison operator returns Boolean. And then we checked whether that type that is returned by this guy is of type string. And the result of that was false. To make it simpler, you can take this thing out and just put the variable in here. So in this case, variable that is called my variable contains value true. And then if we check whether this variable data type is string, is exactly what will be done by this block. Let's rerun it. And you see it is false simply because this variable contains Boolean. Now, if we were to replicate this block, and inside of our variable, we will put some text. We should put some, here's our text. And in here, let's type in the word Bob, and then replicate this print again. So now variable that is called my variable contains string. And then we check the data type of this variable, whether it is string again. And let's see what happens now. So the first result is false. It is from here. And then the second result is true, simply because at this point, the variable my variable contains a string, and that is indeed of type string. And then a couple of interesting things here. So the same variable at first contained a Boolean value. We checked whether it is of type string. It was not. And then we assigned a string value to that variable and checked the data type of it, and it is string and becomes true. So this is very primitive, but still, but already very important, because you can see how to check the data types of your variables and your values. Now, let's scratch all of this. In fact, let me remove some of these things. And let's say that this variable we do not initialize to anything. So the variable is declared. Here's our declared variable. And initially, it does not have any value. So if we were to compare it of type string, what do you think is going to happen? Let's take a look. It is not a string, so the result is false. But if we were to compare it against undefined, let's see what happens now. It is true. So we know that the variable that has not been initialized, the initial value is undefined. It's not so much value. The initial data type of it is undefined. Likewise, if we were to take that variable and we initialize it to null, and the null is going to be right here. Okay, so then it is not undefined, it is not string, it is not Boolean, it is really null. In this case, if we were to check this variable against undefined, the result is going to be false, because it is not undefined, it is actually null. And to check whether it is null is also possible. So for instance, if we go into logic, and instead of this thing, we check it against null, and this is how we can do it. So we put null on one side, and we put variable on the other side. So we check if variable, my variable, is null. And then let's see what the result is going to be. The result is true. So we know that that variable is null. And that's basically how it goes as far as data type checking. But the important thing to know is that there are strings, numbers, Booleans, undefined, and null. Early on, I mentioned that you can actually compare strings to numbers to Booleans. And that is actually true, because there are some, there is a convention that basically says that value of false technically is the same as the number zero. may not make any sense right now, but just accept it that that's what it is. In fact, let's do that comparison right here. So in here, variable my variable, we will initialize it to false instead of null. Let's change it to false. And now we will compare variable my variable to a number zero. In fact, this may not let us do it right here. Actually, it did. So now here's an interesting thing. So variable that is called my variable is initialized with a value of false. And we're comparing if this variable, it equals zero. Let's see the result of that. The result is true. So in codeless programming system, whenever you have a Boolean value that is false, it will be equal to numeric value zero. And that is an important thing that may come into play in some cases whenever you start building codeless logic. Here's another interesting thing. Let's initialize this variable to an empty string, just like this, and then put this false in here instead of that zero. So what we have now is that the variable that is called my variable contains an empty string, and we are checking whether that empty string equals false. So we're basically taking string literal, which is an empty string that doesn't contain anything inside. It is completely empty. There are no characters in it. And we're checking if that value equals the same thing as the value false of a Boolean data type. And let's see what happens now. The result is true. So again, here's another rule to keep in mind, that in codeless programming language, value, Boolean value false is going to be treated and it will equal empty strings. They are really equivalent from the comparison perspective. And those are the things to keep in mind. That's all I have prepared for you today. I think this is demonstrative enough and it gives you yet another stepping block in your course, in your progression of learning codeless programming. And we will start building and we'll continue building on top of that in our future lessons. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it useful. And as always, happy codeless coding.